Yes, Margaret.
Mr. Saunders is here to see you, Sir John.
Mr. Saunders?
Yes, Sir John.
Well, send him in.
Good morning, Sir John.
Morning, Steve. I thought you'd be on your way to Saxmere by now.
Yes, well, that's rather what I wanted to talk to you about.
Ah, I see. Well, sit down. Now, look, I warned you not to listen to gossip, didn't I?
Well, that's rather difficult. As soon as you mentioned Saxmere...
Yes, I know. Everyone tells you that McLean is a crackpot and that the ministry gave him the Saxmere establishment simply to keep him out of their hair.
Well, is he?
No. I'd call him an enthusiast. The kind that let go.
A fanatic.
Oh, yes, right. He won't bore you, I can assure you of that.
And why didn't you tell me you knew him personally?
The answer to that is that I do and I don't. James McLean and I were up at Cambridge together, and I suppose that's the reason he approached me rather than going to another firm when he wanted to borrow a first-class electronics engineer. He wanted someone I could vouch for personally.
I'm flattered.
Well, don't be. What he means is someone who can keep his mouth shut if the ministry start asking questions.
This doesn't sound like my sort of job.
Well, I can't force you to go, Stephen, you know that. And I won't hold it against you if you refuse. But I would take it as a personal favour if you'd give it a try. It's only for a couple of months. And we won't forget you. Here at AEL.
Saunders? I was beginning to wonder where I could find a taxi around here.
You wouldn't. This time of day, the Yanks wipe the lot. Anything on wheels to get them out of Thirlwall?
Oh, yes, there's a base around here somewhere, isn't there?
Hop in. My name is Ken, by the way. Ken Ryan. We don't go in for surnames much at Saxmere. Charlie, it's Ken. Can you come and fetch us?
Is this the only way to get to Saxmere?
Unless you fancy swimming. We get some stunning sunsets this time of year.
Oh? I shall look forward to those. There's not a lot of traffic on the island, I suppose.
Oh, none at all. That's Cerberus. Robbie?
Ken? You okay?
Of course I am. Stop fussing. Call Cerberus, would you?
Sure.
How's that done? Some sort of hypersonic whistle?
Not exactly. There it is. Home sweet home. If you're keen on bird watching, you've come to the right spot. Avocets breed here in spring.
I'm surprised it is such a godforsaken spot. The desire to breed hasn't withered away entirely.
You'd be surprised. Last March, I heard the bittern boom.
Where are the armed guards, the punishment block? And these are the sleeping quarters, I take it.
That's a whole caboodle. Where we sleep, work, feed, everything.
Forgive my ignorance, but my briefing before I left AEL was somewhat short. Now I come to think about it, I don't know the first thing about Saxmere or what you're doing here.
The official version or the unofficial?
I see.
Mac will explain all that.
Can I get a drink round here?
Sure. Coffee, cocoa, orange juice.
Yes, well, there's no need to take this thing too far, you know.
I would like a scotch. Oh, we none of us touch it. Alcohol, I mean, it's one of Mac's things. You could always buy your own supply in the pub, keep it in your room.
My God. Is this a Carmelite or a Franciscan order?
Well, certainly isn't Trappist. Come and meet Mac. Mac?
Oh, God damn it to hell! What do you think you're doing?
I want to meet Mr. Saunders. He's Ooh. Just arrived. He's from...
I know exactly where he's from. Ah, forgive me. Stephen, isn't it?
Yes.
Now, there's one thing I can't stand. It's having my concentration broken.
There's one thing Mac can't stand. It's being beaten at ping pong.
Rubbish!
Super Janus.
Where did the rest of the personnel eat?
Well, the entire personnel of this establishment are in the room right now. The most important member being Janus here.
Right.
Followed by Robbie.
The Johannes factotum.
That's excellent, Janus.
I do everything from exploding gases to taking Ken's temperature.
And exercising the dog.
When in trouble, send for me.
And it's me. My job is to make the mistakes so that the others have something to do cleaning up the mess.
Absolutely.
Ken? Oh, I'm the special case. I'm just the guinea pig, along with Janice's daughter and Severus the dog.
Is it past your bedtime, Ken?
Sorry.
Don't leave too late.
I've been to check at 9:30.
Good night.
Bye. Bye.
Is he in training for something?
Something like that. Now, this is Robbie's department.
Very impressive.
You can do anything here, from developing a virus to taking out your tonsils.
I hope it won't come to that.
Now, you'll feel more at home in here.
Well, now, this is like the Hermes unit we built for the GPO.
Yes, I've christened it Karen 1. But it is the Hermes unit, with variations.
Karen?
The ferryman, you know, over the River Styx.
And what does this do?
Well, that's a modification we made to the voice synthesizer. It's based on the voice of old Fitzherbert at Cambridge. We picked him because he was a good speaker. But it's not yet entirely satisfactory. That's why we wanted to borrow you from Associated Electronics.
And what are you using the whole system for now?
Well, primarily I'm using it for certain experiments in the field of hypnosis. These involve programming it with a series of questions. The answers are then fed back into the computer instantaneously, and they modify the questions that follow.
Are you joking?
By no means.
You've done that?
Well, the blundering amateur can occasionally see the shape of the forest, you know, without knowing all that much about the trees.
Then what on earth do you need me for?
Oh, many things. On Karen 1, for instance, we've still got a degree of hesitation in the voice mechanism. It makes our hypnosis work difficult occasionally. Listen.
This is Charon 1. This is Charon 1.
Let's try the yes-no trick. Commence interrogation.
Male?
Yes.
Cooking, cleaning, or maintenance work?
No.
Trained in medicine?
No.
Trained in physics?
To some extent.
Please reply with yes or no.
Yes.
Electronics?
Yes.
Computers?
Yes.
But you hear the hesitations.
Well, I'd have to dismantle this synthesizer, but you've got further than we have at AEL.
Well, it's had many uses, particularly in the medical field, but... Well, I won't go into the details tonight, but the experiments I'm using it for, the Ministry knows nothing whatever about, and must remain in that state of ignorance. Oh, that's what they know about. That's the sort of thing they're interested in. Care on, too.
And what does this do? What the hell was that?
Controlled high-frequency transmission.
And directionalized?
To a pinpoint.
I can see why the Ministry would be interested.
Oh, yes, they're always interested in new methods of destruction. But it has other uses. High-frequency response between individuals. Demonstration?
Yes.
We've achieved a range of 4.5 miles with this so far, but we can go further.
Impressive. But surely that's just an extension of those old-fashioned hypersonic dog whistles.
Ever heard of a dog whistle that works on humans, though? Well, it's not all that late. I'm sure Mrs. Janus will forgive me. But I do so enjoy showing off. I'm sorry, Mrs. J. Just an experiment. Well, sorry if I woke her up. Yes, put her on. Hello, Nicky. No, it's all right. You can go back to bed. Well, sleep time. See, children like dogs are particularly easy to train. Their sixth sense, the one that picks up these signals, is highly developed. Nicky has her own call note, just as Cerberus does. Call Cerberus, can't wait. And the fact that she's retarded makes her an excellent subject.
You can prove that certain high-frequency signals can be used not only to destroy, but to stimulate the brain at great distances.
Yes, but that's not all. Do you know anything about poltergeists?
Poltergeists? Things that go bump in the night.
But Mrs. Jane has had trouble with things that go bump in the night long before I developed camp. And saucepans, ferrets, and so on, hurling themselves at the cottage. It was Nicky, of course.
The child?
Yes, she didn't know it, neither did her parents, but the force is extra strong in her case, because her brain's in the way. And since she's the only survivor of identical twins, the force is doubled.
Come on.
Can you think of a better explanation? Exactly. No one ever has. We all possess an untapped source of energy within us which awaits release. I call it Force 6.
And this is your explanation of poltergeists?
Oh, yes, and telepathy, precognition, and other mysteries.
And it's similar to the energy in the high-frequency impulse that I released just now from Charon 2. The one that shattered the glass and woke Nikki from sleep. And I believe that the energy we develop in any electronic device is similar to the energy, that extraordinary energy that the Janus child possesses. With one difference. We've been able to control the one, but not the other. Until now.
Right. So, you tap this energy. It's force six. You have us all breaking glasses, chucking furniture about. Wouldn't that just add to our difficulties by returning us to that chaos from which presumably we sprang?
Yes, no doubt it would, but that's not what I'm after. A man will find an ordinary, everyday use for force six in his own good time. But I want to make it work for him in a different way. I want to make it work for him after the body dies.
Good morning.
Oh.
Well, you certainly do yourselves well for food around here, I will say.
You're proposing to back out, I imagine.
I'm an electronics engineer. I'm not interested in psychical research.
No. Lister's colleagues weren't concerned with discovering antisepsis. And what fools they look to us now.
So you believe in all this stuff about force six?
You don't?
Look, I can accept the work McLean's done on sounds. Somehow found an answer to voice production that we never could at AEL. He's also managed to produce a system of high-frequency signals that can somehow communicate themselves to a dog and one idiot child. Full marks for the first, doubtful about the value of the second, and as for the third, well, the whole idea of capturing this force six.
Hi. Look, if Mac doesn't need you in the control room, I'll show you around later this morning. We could go over to Saxmere Cliff.
Well,
Great. No use asking Robbie for anything. Spend the morning in the lab, gloating over specimens of my blood.
What exactly does Ken do around here? Said something last night about being a guinea pig.
He's dying. 3 months at most.
Dying?
Leukemia.
And McLean's using him?
Yeah.
For this ludicrous theory of his?
Ken believes in it. It's all right, there'll be no pain.
That is not the point.
Have you ever watched anyone die?
No. No, I haven't.
Well, I'm a doctor, so it's part of my job, but I'll be glad of some help during Ken's last few weeks.
Hello?
The energy's there, you know. You can't destroy energy. You can only convert it into something else. So, what happens to 4-6 at the point of death?
You mean when Ken dies?
Yes. Look, I'll be perfectly frank with you, Steve. I asked John Fowler not to tell you, but your predecessor wouldn't cooperate.
And I'm not sure that I can either. And I didn't know I had a predecessor.
Oh, yes, he was a Catholic. Believing as he did in the survival of the soul and its sojourn in purgatory, he couldn't stomach the idea of the soul being imprisoned and made to work for us here on Earth. You and I, of course, not concerned with souls. We know the intelligence dies with the body, but not that vital spark, the energy. This looks like an ordinary storage unit, doesn't it? But I modified it to receive and contain 4-6 when it's available. I call it Charon 3, but there's an intermittent fault in the decoding circuit. Sometimes selects the wrong location.
Well, perhaps I could have a quick look. I see the read strobe.
A Charon 3 screen here will display a signal if we're successful. Ken has only 3 months to live at the most, you know. His life is forfeit anyway. If the experiment fails, we've lost nothing. But if it succeeds, we shall have found an answer at last to the intolerable futility of death.
Last beaches where they nest on this coast. Look. Keep down.
You'd think it was a black tern except for the forked tail, wouldn't you?
Well, I don't know very much about it, I'm afraid. Did you make a note of all the birds you see?
Only the rarer ones. Oh. Come on. Let's pay our respects to Mrs. J.
Are you all right?
Of course I am.
I'm fine.
Nicky? Is your mummy in? Are you there, Mr. Jade?
It must get a bit bleak here in the winter.
I don't mind the cold.
But don't you find it rather isolated?
I prefer the frost to the damp.
Mac wants me.
Oh, excuse me. Yes? Nicky, Mac wants to speak to you.
Is she never wrong? That's a lovely photograph of Nicky.
That's not Nicky, that's her twin.
It's Penny. She was drowned soon after they both turned 5.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Mac wants you both in the control room. He's going to do a practice run.
But suddenly she seemed to become intelligent.
Yes, we don't understand that yet. She's very definitely subnormal in ordinary circumstances, but Karen's call signal seems to lift her mental capacity to an extraordinary degree. Would you? Thank you.
It's all right. Robbie's not going to cut me up. Well, at least I hope not.
Robbie has his own theories about Nicky, haven't you, Robbie?
I've got theories about most things. Which one's this?
Well, why she becomes more intelligent under Caron's influence.
Well, I'm convinced it's the effect of the ultra-short waves on the brain's electrical impulses. It's an area we should be exploring for medical purposes.
It may be true, but I have other purposes in mind.
Right, Kitty.
Now, when the call signal goes out from Caron 2, it activates the force 6 in Nikki. And as you know, in her case, the force is doubled because of her dead twin.
You mean the dead sister takes her over?
No, ghosties and ghoulies. There's nothing left of Penny but energy. And it's that energy we want to tap.
That's what I'm here for. Are you any interested in getting my force 6 into that machine when I die?
You'll find this very interesting, Steve. We start with a hypnosis routine, and that's done by numbers.
I want to try the cardiogram monitors, Matt.
Okay, encephalograph.
Okay, ready when you are. I'll relieve you of this.
Commence hypnosis. This is Caron speaking. 6-1-5-1. 6-1-5-1. Are you okay, Ken? Does anything bother you, Ken?
It's this hanging about. If it could be over and done with, I wouldn't give a damn.
All human beings must die. You are only going ahead of the rest.
It's lonely, though, knowing they'll all still be here when I'm gone.
But if the experiment works, the most important part of you will still be here.
My 4-6? Does it really exist? Is it real?
It is you. It is what gives you life.
Like a lot of vultures standing around waiting for my blood to rot.
Of course you feel that. It is natural that you should.
It's all right for them, but I'm frightened.
You will be all right, Ken. You are not alone. We are with you every step of the way. Okay?
Okay.
6-1-5-1. 6-1-5-1. Wake up, Ken.
Did old Caron do his stuff?
100%.
You okay?
Great.
Whoa.
Yeah, I always feel marvelous afterwards.
Let's just get these things off.
Hypnosis by machine.
Exactly. He's preconditioned for the electronic voice. Well, we felt it would be essential when the time comes to eliminate any possibility of our own emotions in Julie.
I can't imagine that they would. Sorry, somewhat cheap.
No, I realize it's difficult for you coming in halfway.
But the sophistication of that man-machine interaction is incredible.
The child's condition, too.
Well, the subnormal.
Nicky, yeah. Marvelous subject. You see, Ken will undoubtedly go into coma toward the end. We'll have no way of contacting him, even through Karen 1. Nicky will have to go with him as far as she can. And she'll be our only link with Ken.
Won't that be dangerous for him?
No, I don't think so. No. I don't see why, John. All right, Ken.
Great. An orange juice with a dash of soda?
This is on you, is it, Mac?
You know forehand, Steve, that's your problem.
I haven't got much backhand either.
Well, you put a bit of work into that forehand. You'll find it'll pay dividends. Ready? Game.
Now.
Oh.
We can't just go on ignoring them.
What's up?
Oh, we keep getting letters from your boss. They want you back.
I can't leave now, not yet.
Well, that's up to you, of course.
Sir John also says he bumped into the minister the other day and he says he's on the warpath.
Ah, that nincompoop.
Well, nincompoop he may be, but he's asking questions about our appropriation. Huh? He wants to send a team down.
No. Do you want to go back, Steve?
No, not yet. Not until we've finished.
Good. Go up to London, see John and tell him that.
Well, I could telephone.
No, go up and see him. You could do the day off. And while you're about it, you might just drop a casual word in his ear. It'll get back to the minister.
I see.
Oh, you know, I'm no good at this politicking.
Not much.
No, just something to keep off the snoopers until next year. They can come down then and we'll shatter a few beakers for them. They'll enjoy that. Cheers.
Cheers.
I think you'd be well out of it, Stephen. I really do. But what I don't understand is your change of attitude. I mean, I had the devil's own job persuading you to get a Saxmere.
Well, Mac can be pretty persuasive, too.
Yes, I bet he can. But let me tell you, the minister is going to come down on him like a ton of bricks. Unless he has something worthwhile to show.
Well, he's on the verge of something extraordinary. Oh, anything that destroys his concentration now, it might blow the whole thing.
You've been down there now for 3 months. It won't do your reputation any good if there's another scandal with Mac.
Can't you use your influence with the minister, sir? Just hold him off for a week or so.
Yes, I could. It's possible, but why should I? Now, look here, what is it that McLean is on the verge of? Can you tell me?
Oh, no. Except that it's the culmination of his work into high-frequency signals. It's pretty revolutionary.
Yes, maybe. But I can't hold this job at Bristol open for you indefinitely. You understand?
But what can I do? Desert Mac now?
Stephen, I'm not threatening.
No, I know that.
I genuinely don't know when another opportunity like this would come along for you.
Look, Sir John, I think I can tell you that... Well, one of the byproducts of the work we've been doing are the modifications we've made to the Hermes unit.
The Hermes?
Well, we've taken the question and answer pattern way, way beyond the yes-no stage. Could be good for AEL.
Yes. All right, Stephen. I'll see what I can do with the minister.
Hello, Janus. Where's Ken?
He's got a cold. Robbie's keeping him in bed.
How's Ken?
He's got some fever. This could be it. How did you get on?
I think I've held him off for a bit.
Well, we don't want them here now.
Did you manage to hold off the Whitehall warriors?
I think so. They're not very fearsome, just a little bit dogged.
Not unlike our own dear leader.
That's true. Now you've got a cold, I hear.
Robbie's making a fuss about nothing. I suppose I got my feet wet stuffing a bird down on the marsh.
He's got an infection in the right lung. With leukemia, that could be fatal. The next 48 hours should tell one way or the other.
Do you know what conflict is? I didn't until now. For years I've waited for this moment, but... I don't want Ken to die.
You fancy a game?
I prefer real competition. Where are you going?
Going for a walk.
No, we may need you.
Look, I can't stand this hanging around.
No, all right, but we'll take service with you. And if he gets called back, come with him. And quickly.
Time flies.
Tell Matt.
Ken's worse. Janus is helping Robbie give him a blood transfusion.
A last resort.
More of a forlorn hope. We'll need subroutines 41 to 54.
41 to 54. Right. What's the verdict?
Not too good, Ken.
Oh. You gotta go. It's 41 to 54 ready.
Ready?
Transfusion no good? Or is it worth trying another?
It wouldn't prolong his life by as long as it took to give it him. He's going fast.
Is he conscious?
Yes. I'll bring him through.
Oh, get Nicky in first.
Oh, yes. I'll take her in now, Mr. James. Don't worry, Mr. J. It'll be just like all the other sessions she's had.
Poor Ken.
Yes, he's been magnificent. Come on, Nicky.
Cardiogram. Okay. Encephalograph.
Encephalograph. Okay. Ready when you are?
Steve.
What's happening?
It's all right, Ken. Just relax. We've Just got you into the lab for a few more tests.
Some tests? I hope it works out for you, Mac.
Thanks, Ken.
Better get on with it, though.
Mac.
Commence hypnosis. This is Charon speaking. This is Charon speaking. 6151. 6151. Are you okay, Ken?
No.
What is the matter?
You know damn well what's the matter.
Steve.
Where are you, Ken?
In the lab.
How do you feel?
Cold. Robbie's turned the heating off. What's he turned the heating off for?
Everything is as it should be, Ken.
What's the idea, is it? To freeze me like butcher's meat.
46.
That's the idea, is it? To freeze me. Freeze.
You are 5 years old, Ken. You are 5 years old. Why not?
43.
She can't. Nobody can. I'm ill.
Where are you, Ken?
I don't know where I am. I don't like it.
What does it look like? What does it look like?
I don't like it. I'm standing by the cave. A tunnel. They want me to go into the tunnel.
Who do?
At the other end. It's a tunnel. There's something moving there.
Why do they want you to go into the tunnel?
I don't know. Maybe it's not. It isn't there? But I've got to go in there. I've got to.
Stand by. Oxygen.
Got to.
51.
Nikki, tell Ken you are here.
Ken's sick. He's crying.
Tell him you are with him, Nikki.
He doesn't want to play. He's walking away from me.
Make Ken talk, Nikki. Make Ken talk, Nikki.
He won't talk.
Make Ken talk, Nikki. Talk to Ken, Nikki.
He's saying his prayers.
Talk to Ken.
Pity my simplicity, suffer me to come to you.
Talk to Ken, Nikki. Talk to Ken.
I can't. He's walking away. There's a tunnel.
Talk to Ken, Nikki.
He's gone into a
coma. I can't go in the tunnel. It's too dark.
How long is he going to be in a coma?
I'm not allowed in the dark.
Could be hours.
I told you are not allowed in the dark tunnel.
Give me oxygen.
Go after Ken, Nikki.
No.
I'll take him.
It's black. I don't want to go. I'm not allowed.
The child's pulse is racing.
Stay with Ken, Nikki. Tell us what happened.
Won't she go into coma too?
Stay with Ken, Nikki.
Well, how the hell do you know you can bring her back? Quiet!
Stay with Ken, Nikki. Tell us what happens. Stay with Ken, Nikki. Tell us what happens. Stay with Ken, Nikki.
He's going.
Tell us what happens. Stay with Ken, Nikki. Tell...
dead.
Nothing on Charon 3. Still nothing. Yes. Yes. Robbie.
Child.
Huh? Oh, yeah.
I'll wake her.
No!
Why not?
Oh, let's hear what she's got to say first. What happened to Ken at the end of that tunnel?
What's all this about?
Shut up, Bobby.
This is Charon 1, Nicky. This is Charon 1, Nicky. Where is Ken? Where is Ken? Where is Ken?
He wants you to let him go.
What does he mean?
That's what he wants. Let him go. Let 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 go.
What does he mean?
Let go. Let go.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
He's choking to death.
You stupid bastard.
9735. 9735. Wake up, Nicky.
I want to go to the toilet.
I'll take you.
Green started pulsing faster when the child was rocking backwards and forwards.
Well, if you hadn't panicked and woken her up, we might have found out.
She could have died, for God's sake.
No, I don't think so. I don't think so. You know what I was reminded of? The shock of birth. Her gasping for air was like an infant struggling for breath. Ken, in coma, had gone back to that moment. Nicky was with him.
No, Mac. Nicky started struggling and choking after Ken had died. After the signal had appeared on that screen. So how could he go back to the moment of birth when he was already dead?
I don't know. I just don't know. Cerberus won't let me sleep.
There's something wrong here, Mac.
Wrong?
When Nicky said he wants you to let him go, Ken was already dead. So, what was it that was asking us to let it go?
You are 5 years old, Ken.
That amorphous lump of energy you call 4-6. Can that communicate thought on such a sophisticated level?
The tunnel. They want me to go into the tunnel.
or has something else happened? Something that we know to be impossible. That what you have trapped in that machine of yours is not just energy, but the essence of Ken himself. That thing that we know can't possibly exist. His soul.
Where is Ken?
He wants you to let him go.
What does he mean?
That's what he wants. Let him go! Let go! Let go! Let go!
What?
What have we done, Mac?
No, she's not feverish. She won't eat or speak, and she's afraid of the dark. Now, try the call signal. It may calm her down.
All right, keep your hair on. Steve, try Nikki's call signal, will you?
Nikki, right.
We'll just switch you on. What happened, Robbie? What happened?
Mac, quickly, the screen!
Turn off the call signal. Robbie, where the hell are you, Robbie?
What is it?
Bring her back here.
No.
I'll get her back here, and fast.
Hospital.
This is Charon 1, Nikki. This is Charon 1, Nikki. Are you all right, Nikki?
I don't know. There's a clock ticking somewhere. I don't like the clock. I don't like the clock. I don't like the clock.
Are you all right, Nikki?
For Christ's sake, Max, stop it.
Where is the clock, Nikki?
Around. It's ticking in my head. Penny doesn't like it either.
Why doesn't Penny like it?
Penny!
You'll
Ken.
Kill her! No, Mac!
Ken!
Bring her out, Steve!
Ken!
Leave
Penny,
it alone.
What
Ken.
Does Ken want, Nikki? What does Ken want, Nikki?
Let them go! Let them go! Let them go! Let them go! Let
Please,
go!
Mac.
Let go! Let go! Let go! Let go! Let go! 9735.
This is Charon 1. Wake up, Nikki.
You may be right. Perhaps intelligence, soul, or whatever you like to call it, does survive after the body's death.
And immortality is a certainty.
Proved by a computer.
What are you doing?
Heard what they said. Let them go.